Magnificat anima mea Dominum.
Thank you.
vel puerum sum. Recordatus misericordiae suae.
Thank you. So the next two pieces by J.S. Bach take the hymn, the Luther hymn based on the Magnificat, and the first piece is a chorale prelude, so this would have been done probably as an introduction to actually singing the hymn. And it's actually borrowed from one of his cantatas, cantata number 10. Bach did several settings of the Magnificat. One is a big choral work, essentially a cantata that probably many of you know, and it's actually been performed here at St. Luke several times. He also did a smaller cantata based on the hymn, Meine Seele erhört den Herrn. And the fifth verse of that, which is the Sushemt Israel verse, the verse that refers to God's faithfulness to the people of Israel, he quotes the Tonus Peregrinus tune in the cantata, played by the trumpet while a tenor and an alto sing that verse, but not to that tune underneath it. They sing the words to this sort of dance-like rhythm. And very near the end of Bach's life, he put this piece to organ, and so the organ takes the voices and the trumpet line and everything. And then following that, a very large fugue based on the Tonus Peregrinus. The fugue theme enters 8 different times, and in Bach's typical genius way, to make it even more complicated, 2 of those times it's in canon. So the voice enters, and then 2 beats later it enters again in another voice in a row, row, row your boat sort of fashion. And how you can do that with a tune as complicated as this, only somebody like Bach could do that. I wanted to dedicate this portion of the program to Gene Robinson, a very dear member of the St. Luke family who passed away last week, and who is a very strong supporter of the organ program and the music program at St. Luke. So this bit is for her.
Thank you.
So now we'll move into the Romantic era. I have to say, this is the French Romantic organ in St. Luke, but so far we've heard everything but. And I think the organ serves that literature remarkably well also. Joseph Rheinberger was a pivotal figure in the development of organ music, but he's not all that well known nowadays. He was a professor of composition in Munich. He's probably the only famous composer from Liechtenstein. He really, his gifts of counterpoint and harmony brought a seriousness to the Romantic organ tradition that perhaps had not been there before, but his music is also very inventive and lively. His fourth organ sonata, which was one of 20 that he composed, and these 20 sonatas are probably second in importance in the organ literature only to those of Felix Mendelssohn. The fourth sonata quotes the Tonus Peregrinus, but he doesn't label this piece in any way to signify the importance of that. But it does come in the second section of the first movement. It's very easy to hear. And then it reappears again at the very conclusion of the piece at the end of the third movement. He clearly identifies this with nativity themes. The second movement of this piece, which is also unlabeled, he actually recycled in a cantata that he did for Christmas called the Son is Born. He uses it in the movement where the shepherds appear. So which the second movement is shepherd music. Thank you. Now for a switch to France, and two French takes on this German take, on a Latin tune, on a Hebrew tune. Marcel Dupré's hymn arrangement is modeled after Bach's. It's very short, also very chromatic, just like the Rheinberger that we just heard. And then the piece that follows by Jean Langlais is part of an interesting collection called the Ecumenical Book. And what Langlais does is pair up movements in which he takes a Gregorian chant and a Protestant hymn tune that addresses the same theme that the chant does and pairs them up with one another. In the case of the Magnificat, the Marian anthem that he chooses is Ave Maris Stella. And Ave Maris Stella has an interesting, maybe it's a coincidence, but I think it's deliberate in why he chooses it, in that the first few notes of the Ave Maris Stella are, the last few notes of the Ave Maris Stella are actually the first few notes of the Tonus Peregrinus. And so in the Ave Maris Stella movement, you will hear him actually quote both of these. He'll deploy the Gregorian chant, and then right toward the end, you actually hear the German hymn tune, the Tonus Peregrinus, following, and then the separate movement that's dedicated to that one.
Thank you.
piece on today's program kind of harkens back to Samuel Scheidt in a way, but sort of a 20th century take on it by Hermann Schroeder, who was a professor of music at the Music Academy in Cologne for many, many years. His variations on the Tonus Peregrinus doesn't say that it is supposed to be a verse-by-verse allusion to the Magnificat. However, as it happens, there are 10 variations, and there are 10 verses to the Magnificat, and I think it's sort of logical to pair them up. So see if you agree.